Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab, Introducing Reference Noise in ADC Systems. This module begins with a discussion about how reference noise enters your signal chain and how it's characterized by an ADC, continues by delving into the reference's impact on system noise, and closes with a calculation and simulation of voltage reference output noise using a component's datasheet. Follow-up presentations discuss how a voltage reference noise affects ADC performance, as well as ways to minimize reference noise. To begin, let's first consider the ultimate goal that we are trying to accomplish. Shown here is a simplified signal chain block diagram consisting of an amplifier, an ADC, and a voltage reference. Throughout the Precision Lab's ADC modules on noise, the goal has been to understand how noise enters the system and how noise affects each component. With this knowledge, you can then determine the total noise for a system like the one shown here and represented by the equation at the bottom of the slide. Two of the three terms in this total noise equation have been discussed in detail in the previous Precision Lab's modules, ADC noise and amplifier noise. In both cases, you can use these presentations to determine the input referred noise for each component. This module focuses on the third term, using the superposition principle to focus on and determine an equation for the input referred voltage reference noise. Doing so helps illustrate how reference noise interacts with the other noise sources shown here, as well as how reference noise affects the overall system performance. Given that the goal is clear, let's delve deeper into this topic by identifying how reference noise enters the signal chain. To understand how reference noise enters your system, let's expand the signal chain shown on the previous slide to include additional components. This signal chain is taken from the Precision Lab's modules on effective noise bandwidth and consists of two distinct paths. First is the input path, highlighted in red, which includes an amplifier and an ADC. The second path is the reference path in blue, which can include a filter and a buffer. The Delta Sigma ADC's digital filter serves as an intersection point between these two paths and is highlighted in purple. The digital filter acts on a Delta Sigma ADC's modulated bitstream, which is equal to the maximum code value scaled by the ratio of the RMS input signal and the reference voltage per the output code equation shown here. Therefore, the digital filter can bandlimit both the input noise and the reference noise in a Delta Sigma ADC. This would not be the case for a SAR ADC, though the output code equation is valid for either ADC architecture. One other important characteristic of the output code equation is that the RMS reference noise directly affects the ADC's output. Given this relationship, it is fair to assume that the noise reported in an ADC's datasheet must include some reference noise. The next slide discusses when this is true. When you input a non-zero signal to the ADC, the ADC's output code includes some reference noise. This is the case for characterizing SAR or wideband Delta Sigma ADCs using the input sine wave test, as shown on the left. ADC datasheet parameters such as SINAD and SNR include some reference noise. Therefore, if your design uses a system similar to the ADC's testing setup, you can reasonably expect to achieve datasheet noise performance. Comparatively, applying a 0-volt input to characterize an ADC results in no reference noise seen in the output code. This is true for parameters that use the input short method, such as effective resolution or noise-free bits, and is represented by the image and equation on the right. However, real systems always need to be able to measure non-zero input voltages, so reference noise will always have some effect on the ADC's conversion result. Is there a way to generalize the impact that reference noise has on the system? The next slide derives an expression for this relationship by manipulating the output code equation shown here. The table on the left begins with the output code equation shown on the previous slide, restated here in step 1. The goal is to manipulate this equation such that there are distinct signal and noise terms. To accomplish this, step 2 multiplies the equation by VREF divided by VREF. This does not change the result of the output code equation as long as you assume that VREF is greater than 0. Next, simplify the modified equation in step 2 by employing the binomial approximation in step 3. If you would like to learn more about this topic and how this transformation is performed, review the information provided at the link in the top right. Once this is completed, distributing the Vn divided by Vref term results in the equation shown in step 4. This equation has two parts, the code value for the input signal, highlighted in red, and the code value for the reference noise, highlighted in blue. Note that reference noise only shows up in the second term in this equation, which is the desired outcome. Finally, take this second term and convert it back to volts by using the equation in step 5 on the right. Multiplying by the reference voltage and dividing by the maximum code value yields the equation highlighted in yellow. The voltage reference's input referred noise is the total reference noise scaled by the ratio of the input signal to the reference voltage. Or in practical terms, the more of the ADC's full-scale range that you use, the more reference noise you let into your system. Let's plot this equation as a function of input signal to better understand the result. For this example, let's assume the reference voltage is 2.5 volts, the total reference noise is 10 microvolts RMS, and the input is a DC signal that is swept from 0 volts to positive full scale. These conditions are summarized on the left. The plot on the right represents the amount of reference noise passed to the system as the input signal changes in 0.25 volt increments. As shown, the changing input signal can also be quantified by how much of the full-scale range is used, or full-scale utilization. Given the equation in the top left corner of the plot, the reference noise scales linearly as the input increases. For example, a 0-volt input signal does not pass any reference noise to the system, while a 1-volt input allows 40% or 4 microvolts RMS of the reference noise into the signal chain. At Vn equals 2.5 volts or a full-scale input, the system sees the total reference noise of 10 microvolts RMS since the RMS value of a DC signal is just the DC signal. AC signals follow the exact same relationship, though the math can be more complex since these terms need to be expressed in RMS. However, you can verify this relationship using simulation tools. Similar to the previous example, the schematic on the left measures a 2.5 volt peak, 1 kHz sine wave input against a 2.5 volt DC reference voltage with a 10 microvolt RMS broadband noise component. The sine wave input signal's RMS value is calculated to be 2.5 volts divided by the square root of 2, though the reference noise equation applies equally to other input signal types, such as square or triangle waves. Plugging all of these values into the reference noise equation yields an expected output noise of 7.08 microvolts RMS, as highlighted in yellow. To verify the expected result with simulated data, two controlled sources are used to plot the system's code voltage and the resulting VREF noise as a function of time. The output equations for each controlled source are shown in the schematic, while the plots on the right show the input signal as well as compare the reference noise contributed by the source and the reference noise seen by the ADC. Specifically, the green plot confirms that the reference source's noise is broadband in nature and has a value of 10 microvolt RMS, while the blue plot confirms the reference noise seen by the ADC is 7.08 microvolts RMS. You can also see from the shape of each plot how the sinusoidal input modulates the reference noise signal, removing some of the noise power and lowering the overall reference noise seen by the ADC. Therefore, even with a full-scale sinusoidal input, not all of the reference noise is passed to the ADC. Now that we have confirmed the reference noise equation, let's move on to understand how to calculate voltage reference noise. As an example, let's use the REF6025, a low-noise 2.5-volt reference with integrated buffers. On the left is the noise spectral density plot from the REF6025's datasheet, while on the right is the portion of the electrical characteristics table describing the output noise. One important feature of the REF6025's noise spectral density plot is that it has significant low frequency noise as well as a flatter broadband noise region. For the simulations on the previous slide, we assumed the reference noise was entirely broadband to keep the analysis simple. This does not change the previously derived reference noise equation, but it does complicate the RMS voltage noise calculations. Fortunately, the low frequency noise is called out in the electrical characteristics table and is calculated here as 7.5 microvolts of peak-to-peak noise from 0.1 Hz to 10 Hz. Assuming a crest factor of 6.6, the resulting RMS voltage noise is approximately 1.14 microvolts RMS. If your reference path's effective noise bandwidth was any other frequency, for example 100 Hz, you would have to calculate the reference's total noise output using the plot on the left. However, you calculate reference noise using the same methods as you would use to calculate amplifier noise, so there are no new equations to learn once you've reviewed the Amplifier Noise Precision Labs modules. Moreover, you can use the information in the Precision Labs module on effective noise bandwidth to learn how to calculate this parameter for any signal path. Additionally, you can use simulation tools to help calculate the reference noise seen by your system. The next slide discusses this topic in more detail. If a SPICE model is available for your component, you can generally find it on the device's product folder on TI.com. The REF6025 model is shown here on the left, with basic connections included. Running a total noise analysis of the circuit on the left yields the total RMS voltage noise plot on the right. The noise at 10 Hz bandwidth is called out at 1.17 microvolts RMS. This is very similar to the 1.14 microvolts RMS value calculated on the previous slide, providing confidence in the simulated results. Moreover, you can now use the plot on the right to quickly check the noise at any bandwidth. For example, the total noise at 100 Hz is 2.06 microvolts RMS, as this bandwidth was also discussed on the previous slide. Since we have analyzed the effects of broadband noise only as calculated and simulated total noise, let's take a closer look at the effects of low frequency noise before moving on to ADC performance analysis. When we initially confirmed the reference noise equation using simulation tools, we used a purely broadband noise source to keep the analysis simple. If the noise were purely broadband, performing an FFT on the captured data would result in a plot similar to the one shown on the left. A distinct fundamental spike at the 1 kHz input signal frequency and a relatively flat noise floor. However, voltage references typically include a significant low frequency or 1 over F noise region, similar to the REF6025's noise spectral density shown previously. This is represented by the plot in the middle. Since this noise is not Gaussian in nature, it does not distribute uniformly throughout the frequency spectrum. Moreover, the very low frequency nature of this noise makes it challenging to filter out. Therefore, the reference's 1 over F noise shows up in the low frequency region as expected, but also tends to reflect around the fundamental, causing the skirting effect shown in the plot on the right. This increased noise around the fundamental frequency can reduce the overall system SNR and often dominates the overall system noise performance compared to the voltage reference's broadband noise. Carefully consider the 1 over F noise magnitude of your voltage reference when choosing a component. Now you are ready to apply the information in this module to the signal chain shown on the first slide. Check out the next Precision Labs module to learn more about how reference noise affects ADC performance. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content. Question 1. How will applying a DC input signal impact the system noise due to the voltage reference? The correct answer is B. The reference noise at the output will be directly proportional to the DC input signal. Question 2. True/False. When applying a sinusoidal input, the output reference noise will be proportional to the RMS of the sine wave. The correct answer is A. True. Question 3. How does the 1 over F noise in the voltage reference show up in the ADC output spectrum? The correct answer is C, both A and B.